children. So Jesus was describing to us. So he says, God, he was wanting us to know that from there, he wants us to know that there's a difference between rich in this world and rich in the world to come. Rich in the life to come. Jesus wants you to be rich forever. Not for 50 years and can experience dire poverty in your life. I'm not talking about reincarnation, I'm talking about life that doesn't end. I'm talking about your soul. I'm talking about when you come back to life at the very end. When you face judgment from God, but God looks at you and says, man, I prepared a place for you. Jesus said that many people will come to me in that day, and in the day of judgment, and many people are judged, and God says enough. Jesus said many people will come to me in that day and say, Lord, Lord, you taught in our streets. But I went to church. No, I don't have that. And many people will say to him, we did all these amazing wonders and did all these wonderful works in your name, Jesus. And he looked at him and he'll say, I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of lawlessness. He said many people will say to him on that day.
Well, that means people that think they're good with God when they're walking around on earth. You know, I'm okay. I'm a good person. I'm not an axe murderer, so I get to go to heaven, right? I give $10 sometimes to homeless people, so I'm going to heaven. That's not how it works. The truth is that true love is the standard. True love. True love is the standard. That it's not our love, it's not the peace and the love that we give and we live by, but the standard of what is good and what is bad is God's kind of love. And that if you do not meet that standard, but you are in need of forgiveness because there is a bounty on your head, and that bounty is to death. But God would have you spared. God would want you to have life and have freedom. And so he didn't just say abracadabra, everyone's forgiven, right? And then wave a magic wand and everyone is all totally forgiven of their sin. He had to pay for us to be forgiven. He didn't just say, well, you know, I'm just going to forgive because, you know, I'm a forgiving person. God is fair. He doesn't play favorites. And so God can't deny his justice, his fairness. And so everything that I've done, there is a payment that needs to be made. Everything you've done, there is a payment that needs to be made. And the question is, will you let Jesus, will you accept the way that he paid for your payment, or will you yourself reject it and have to pay for it yourself? That's the question. That's the ultimate question. That's why when you hear a Christian say, the only way to heaven is Jesus, the only way to God is Jesus, when a Christian says that, it's not because they're bigoted. It's not because they hate you and want you to join their club, because that's what it's all about. When a Christian says that to you, when you've heard that before, the reason it's only Jesus is because Jesus did what no one else would do or could do. But Jesus is the judge. Jesus is God himself. He is the Lord Almighty. And so he is the judge who came and paid for the prisoners.